Hello and welcome to BlastOne's Primed Insight. Today we're going to talk about selecting the right size dust collector for your job. We often get asked, what size dust collector do I need from a blasting project? And it's quite easy to work out. It depends on a few things. There is codes and regulations, but the reason you need a dust collector is, yes, you need to comply with the code, but you also want to protect your operators. The dust loading in a blasting environment can get very, very high, and a blast helmet can only give a certain level of protection. You can't just depend on your blast helmet to entirely protect your operator. You need a certain amount of airflow movement to keep that operator safe. So the code that's generally accepted around the world is, if you're using, in this example we talk about, a horizontal air movement, for non-hazardous dusts, is 80 feet per minute. If you're talking about hazardous dusts, like doing a lead paint removal project, you need 100 feet a minute. That's in a horizontal direction. It's different if you're trying to do a downdraft airflow. But just take this example. Let's take it, we have a containment that's 10 feet by 10 feet. To work out the dust collector size you need, you get your cross-sectional area, so it's 10 feet multiplied by 10 feet. Multiply that by the required airspeed, which is 80 feet per minute, gives you 8,000 CFM dust collector. In the instance of a hazardous coating, like lead paint removal, you get your 10 feet, multiplied by 10 feet is 100, multiplied by 100 feet per minute equals 10,000 CFM dust collector. So that's just a quick and easy way to work out what size dust collector you need. Thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight.